What's up, guys? Welcome back. My name is Steve. Thank you for joining us. Today is a very special video because we are doing the best sneakers under $100 for 2022. The 2021 video has been my most popular video by far, and I very much appreciate each and every person that has watched and liked and commented and copped off the list. And I am very excited to unveil this list with you now. So just like the previous video, we'll go over the ground rules. These are some of the best sneakers under $100 that I think you can buy right now without naming the most obvious ones, right? We know that there's Air Force Ones under $100. We know that there's all kinds of great classic iconic sneakers under $100. This list is going to be filled with sneakers that maybe slide under the radar. They are still very popular. Some are still iconic by all means, but I'm going to be highlighting some specific colorways and some other sneakers that maybe you just haven't quite thought about lately, and something to add to your collection to add a little bit of spice, a little bit of flavor. And another important thing to note, I like to put sneakers in this list that are versatile, that are sneakers you can pair with lots of different fits and looks over the course of the year. So there aren't going to be any crazy outlandish colorways or crazy sneaker silhouettes. These are going to be classic, everyday, great sneakers for a great price that you can wear all year long. All right, now we're gonna get into it, but first, consider joining the fam if you haven't. Hit the like and subscribe notification bell, all that stuff down there. I very much appreciate it because you guys are what makes this sneaker channel great. It's not me, it's you. I appreciate each and every last one of you. And of course, all the links for all of these bangers will be down in the description. Those links help out the channel. I very much appreciate you guys using them. And with that being said, let's get into it. We're starting alphabetically by brand here, so there is no top 10, top 20, whatever. There's no ranking here. This is just an alphabetical list of the best sneakers for 2022, starting with Adidas, of course. And the first one is a sneaker that I thought was going to get some more traction. I thought it was going to get some popularity built up because of the way some other sneakers have been trending. And I think I kind of called that. There were some dope collaborations in 2021 with this model, and this is the Adidas Forum Low. Now, there, of course, are the Forum Mids and Forum Highs, which I will have an all link down there for you as well to check out. But specifically the lows, I love the aesthetic of this, that vintage basketball shoe. Think New Balance 550s, of course, which have gotten very popular this year. The Forum Lows are in the same vein. I just love the look of them, especially in this clean white. It's just a great sneaker, an alternative to something like an Air Force One that you can rock on the daily and pair with all kinds of different looks. The Adidas Forum Low, need I say more? Next up is an Adidas sneaker that takes those retro basketball vibes to another level, and this is for someone that really likes the aesthetic and probably one of the more crazier looking shoes on the list, the Adidas Top 10 RB casual sneaker, as it is called now. This has just got that 1970s/80s retro basketball aesthetic nailed. I love this particular colorway. It's got the navy blue with the red. It's a little Paris Saint Germain, I guess, but there are some cleaner colorways, of course, available as well for you to check out. I love this high top look. I like how the silhouette moves more like a J shape, or that the laces are a little bit more slammed and it goes kind of straight up almost with the tongue there. It's a nice shape. It's a retro look. It's super dope. I really think this would look good with joggers, obviously, some kind of tapered sweats, that kind of 80s basketball aesthetic. You know, I think is becoming more and more popular again, an offshoot of the New Balance 550, shall we say. These are the Adidas Top 10 RB. Next up is a sneaker model from Adidas that needs no introduction. The Ultra Boosts have been revolutionary in terms of comfort and running, and really have kind of pushed Adidas forward and kept them up marginally with Nike in terms of relevancy. And then obviously Yeezy's taken the Boost Foam and taken it to another level with their silhouettes. This is the Adidas Ultra Boost 5.0 in a super dope Pride colorway. So obviously a lot of Ultra Boost sneakers are not going to be under $100. You're gonna have a hard time finding those sneakers under $100. This colorway might be a little bold for some, but I think it looks dope. I love that multicolored midsole there, and the black upper keeps it grounded. It's dope. It's got a good cause behind it, and it is an incredible price right now, under $100. I don't think this one's going to last very long. In terms of comfort and style, it's really hard to beat an Adidas Ultra Boost sneaker. So here you go, the Adidas Ultra Boost 5.0 in this Pride colorway, an amazing deal. This next Adidas sneaker here is near and dear to my heart. It's something I've been wearing since I was a kid, playing indoor soccer and then rocking out to school almost every single day. The Adidas Samba really needs no introduction. I do feel like this sneaker is trending in some circles, some niches of fashion people, but it really hasn't gone completely fully mainstream. You know, part of me almost threw in the Adidas Superstar, but that was too obvious. You know, superstars, they're very popular. So the Samba is a little bit sleeker, more toned down, maybe a little bit more more of a retro feeling, like 1970s retro, as opposed to like 80s and 90s retro, the way the Superstars evoke that kind of feel and look. So I love this sneaker, super comfortable. One of my trips to Europe, I wore a pair of Sambas almost every single day and did thousands upon thousands of steps in them, and they held up beautifully. I still have them. Adidas Samba, really one of the best deals at any given time, one of the best sneakers under 100 bucks, and a beautiful aesthetic that's going to be classic and iconic for years to come. And lastly, this is an Adidas silhouette or model that, you know, I haven't been paying much attention to. It hasn't been on my radar because at first it really felt like Adidas was trying to capitalize on some of the Yeezy aesthetic by making a cheaper, dumbed down version on under the Adidas label. And I mean, it's probably still true, but they have done some nice things with this sneaker, the Adidas Azalea, however you pronounce it. Now, there is a caveat here. The one I have pictured, as you can see, is a very tonal colorway. Those are the colorways that I like the best for these sneakers. So something like this, where it's a white and cream, or like a black on gray, something that's more toned down and tonal, as in within the same color palette family, right? The ones that incorporate more primary colors and are a little bit more contrasting, I don't like the look of those as much. I really like the way that these look right here. And of course, not every colorway is going to be on sale, but right now, this beautiful one right here is on sale for under 100 bucks, the Adidas Azalea. Very dope sneaker and has a very trendy aesthetic that's going to be good, at least through 2022. All right, guys, next up is ASICS. And this brand, in my opinion, is criminally underrated. They have some seriously dope sneakers, but sometimes those sneakers can be very expensive and there's not a ton that you can find in that reasonable under $100 price point. However, the first one on this list is at an insane discount right now. These are the ASICS Gel Kayanos. These things are awesome in terms of comfort and feel. They are serious running sneakers, but they're also very comfortable. I've ran the only marathon I'll ever run in my entire life in a pair of ASICS, and I absolutely love them. They saved me, they kept me going. So I'm a big fan for their technical performance, and I happily will wear ASICS, even these hardcore runner style ASICS, for daily use and for lighter runs and whatnot. These right here are just a premium running sneaker that you are getting for under 100 bucks. It's such a great deal, I had to put it in this list, even if it might be a little too technical and performance based for some people. But I think lots of people can work this into their wardrobe and will look great doing it, and there are a lot of colorways on sale right now at that $100 or underneath that $100 price point. Now, this next pair is definitely more in line with everything else I have in this video. This is the ASICS Japan S. This one is a classic white on white, nice retro iconic looking style sneaker that you can swap out the Air Force Ones with. Something just different. That's what I wanted to put on this list. This is one of them, and the price can't be beat, guys. And just look how clean this looks. Just nice, simple, classic sneaker styling, nice off-white midsole there. I've always appreciated how the ASICS logo just kind of blends in with the upper there. It's not an overt stamping. It kind of looks like it's almost just part of the design in a lot of ways. This is the ASICS Japan S, and it really just speaks for itself. You know what you can do with this sneaker. And lastly from ASICS, this one is a little bit more of a retro aesthetic. This is the ASICS Tiger Runner. And to me, this one really feels like a vintage running sneaker, say like the Nike Daybreak or the Nike Challenger for kind of a comparison's sake. That's what I feel when I look at this sneaker here. So if you're into that vintage running sneaker aesthetic, this one has got you covered. I really like this particular colorway. Nice off-white vibes happening here. Really, it's kind of a more retro version of the ASICS Japan S I just showed you. So you kind of pick how vintage you want to go between those two. But I think there's just so many great style applications for both of these sneakers. And these Tiger S's are ones I haven't talked about before ever. And I really, really like the way they're looking right now, the ASICS Tiger Runner. All right, now, assuming I know the alphabet correctly, we have moved on from the A's and we are on to the next brand. That is New Balance. Now, if you haven't been following New Balance, they've had another awesome year with some seriously dope releases, some underrated, some deserving the hype, but New Balance is quickly becoming kind of the number two in the hype section next to Nike, and their models speak for themselves, but they've debuted some dope new models as well as the classics we all know and love, starting off with one of my favorite new models from them, the New Balance XC72. This sneaker was launched with the help of Casablanca. Some really dope collabs have been born from that, but now there are models that are retailing for 100 bucks. And if some go on sale, you're getting an even better deal. But there are ones that start at 100 bucks now, and the colorways look awesome, like what you're seeing here. I just so much to like about this sneaker, the motorsport racing aesthetic, the comfort, the materials, at least on the ones that I've had in hand, are dope. I can imagine they're gonna be great on these $100 pairs pairs as well. Just a really dope new silhouette from New Balance that you're not going to see out there too much. A lot of people go for the classics, and that's understandable. If you want to stand out a little bit, the XC72. Now, keeping in theme with newer models, this is the New Balance 327. And again, this was launched with the help of some really dope collaborations. And now it is branched off and really being its own model with their own releases under just plain old New Balance at a great price point. So obviously you can buy many levels of the 327 with many different materials. The ones that are a little bit cheaper are going to be more of those nylon-y kind of ripstop materials. However, what it's lacking in maybe suede and leather, they are really doing some dope minimal colorways with this sneaker. And I really like the way it looks, especially for what you are getting. I mean, at a price point under $100 or $85, $75 I've seen as a normal retail price, you really hard to beat for a nice quality sneaker like this one. Again, kind of like the XC72, this has a little bit of that driver shoe inspiration, and it's just a really dope, comfortable sneaker that is a bit of a departure, but still keeps the classic lines of what we come to love from New Balance. All right, now this New Balance sneaker is a move away from what we just saw with the 72s and the 327s, and this goes more into that chunkier dad shoe aesthetic, I would say. This is the 5740, and it is a blend of kind of multiple New Balance models, I believe. It is also a newer silhouette that was dropped recently, and some collaborators have done some really dope things with them. Of course, there are some options now, without the collaboration, of course, that you can get for $100 or less. I absolutely love the Bricks and Wood collaboration, and thankfully, New Balance has dropped a very similar colored version that you see here for a ridiculously great price. So if the chunky dad shoe aesthetic is your thing, but you don't want to go too overboard with some of the stuff that like Yeezy puts out or some of the designer shoes, the 5740 is a really nice balance and a very comfortable sneaker, and there are tons of colorways you can find for a great price. That is the New Balance 5740. All right, finally with New Balance, I couldn't leave out one of the classic silhouettes. The problem is some of these silhouettes are so hot, you're not finding a lot of them for under $100, even on sale, because they're just gonna be out of stock. However, the 574 is one that you can always count on, a classic New Balance silhouette that everybody knows and loves, and there are tons of colorways. One in particular that I like is the rugged colorways, and those, as the name suggests, are just made with a little bit more beefier materials, and they lend a different look, and they're not quite as streamlined as some of the other 574s, so I really like the way these look. I think that you're maybe getting a little bit more for your money by going for one of the rugged colorways, but obviously there are tons of 574s that you can find for under $100. It's almost one of those two obvious sneakers, which is why I picked a specific type that they have right now for a great price, the New Balance 574 Rugged. All right, and now that brings us to the king, Nike, and I say that as a big Nike fan, but also just the reality. I mean, everybody is here and Nike is just up here in terms of sneaker sales, volume, hype. I just, they know what they're doing and they are extremely good at it, and everybody else is playing catch up. So needless to say, there are plenty of dope Nike sneakers that you can get under $100 either on sale or just the plain old retail price. Starting with some classics, in my opinion, the Nike Retro GTS. Nike has been steadily dropping more and more colorways of these in really dope materials, canvases and suedes, and they're almost always, from what I can tell, at like $80 to $75 or $90. I haven't seen anything over $100, so there's a lot of optionality here if you catch them when they're released. There are some available right now, of course. I love the canvas ones. I love the suede ones. Comfortable flat platform style shoe, obviously a very popular skate shoe. You really can't go wrong with this low cut profile, and I love the minimal swooshes on the Nike Retro GTSs. They look great. I love that small embroidered swoosh. Just a nice lower key sneaker without the giant branding on it. You can't go wrong. The Nike Retro GTS. Next up is a brand new sneaker model from Nike that has taken the aesthetics and inspiration from one of the most important sneakers in the brand's history. That is the Nike Waffle 1. The Waffle Racers, obviously Bill Bowerman invented them using literally a waffle iron and urethane rubber, and the Nike Waffle 1s pay homage to that sneaker, but they are insanely comfortable with really dope materials. Sometimes they're kind of translucent and they just look really good. They've released so many dope colorways with the Waffle Ones, and they are always at a great price point. I have talked about this sneaker on this channel, and it is very comfortable. It's very dope. It's very versatile. It's one of my favorite sneaker releases, kind of general release sneakers from Nike in a long time. Next up, we have kind of the Nike Blazers as a whole, but the Blazer mids specifically, and I've talked about Blazers on the other videos, but it just has to be included still because Blazers are definitely very popular, but there are a lot of colorways that fly under the radar and you can get for a wonderful price, and I'm particularly fond of the all suede uppers. In the first under $100 video, we had like an all red kind of Raging Bull version. This one here is a gorgeous green and white. I love the way this looks. And of course, the Blazer lows are obviously in play. Other Blazer highs are in play. And you can find so many different great Blazer models at any given time. It's one of those great classic retro sneakers that goes well with just about everything. The Blazers, specifically the mids, but also the lows and also the highs, you can't go wrong. Next up is a sneaker that's in line with the Waffle one that we just talked about, but it is more closer to the icon that is the original Waffle Racer. This is the Waffle Trainer 2, obviously retro aesthetic here. Beautiful sneaker, the Waffle outsole, everything about it is just screams vintage, dope, history. Again, one of the most important Nike models of all time. The brand might not be what it is today without Bill Bowerman and his waffle iron. So it's just something that as a big sneaker fan, if you're a big Nike fan too, especially, something that you would probably want to have in your collection as kind of a signifier of the history of the brand. Of course, if you want to know more about that, I have the Shoe Dog book linked down in the description. Definitely a good read written by Phil Knight himself. And you hear a lot about the Waffle Racers in that book. The Waffle Trainer 2 from Nike. Come on. Here is another retro Nike model that I love and have included in the other videos as well. This is the Nike Killshot, specifically here, the Killshot 2 with the leather upper. You get a nice all leather upper with a beautiful low cut sneaker, retro vibes. What is there not to like? And of course, under $100, just a beautiful aesthetic and maybe a departure from the Blazers. If you have a lot of those or you see a lot of Blazers out, you can switch it up, but still keeping the similar aesthetic with the Killshots. I'm a big fan of Killshots. I have multiple pairs myself, so I always, always gotta recommend if we're talking about sneakers under 100 bucks. Next up is a sneaker that I have a pair on my feet as we speak, and you'll see them in the background of my videos a lot because they are one of my go-to running sneakers. Actually, at this point, they are my go-to running sneakers, but they also offer just crazy dope comfort for everyday use. This is the Nike Pegasus, the 36 and the 37 or the 38s. You really, anything but the current model, you can get for at or under that $100 price point, depending on when you look. I have some linked, obviously, for you to check out. But the Pegasus is one of the longest running sneakers in Nike's history, probably one of the longest running sneaker models ever. It's one of those running sneakers that serious runners, professionals, and amateurs alike all swear by, but it's not a crazy price point to begin with. So once it dips a little bit on sale, you can get them for under $100, and they're just awesome, especially if you're an amateur runner like myself and you want something that's consistent and comfortable and gonna keep your feet healthy. I love the way the Pegasus feels, and it's got a beautiful streamlined look. You really can't go wrong. Okay, I know I said I wasn't gonna have any type of crazy sneakers, but these guys technically aren't sneakers, so I guess I didn't lie to you, but I wanna end the Nike section with something kinda dope in a shoe that I absolutely love and wear almost on a daily basis, kinda moving around in my basement here. These are the Nike Offline 2.0s. I guess they are mules. I would describe them as very heavy sandals, and they are kind of recovery sneakers. They have this incredible foot massaging insole, one of the dopest presentations for an unboxing that you're gonna see, especially for a general release sneaker. And they're heavy, and they want you to take the day off and relax, and they wanna just take care of your feet. So you just kind of walk around in them and get your little foot massage and just be a lot happier wearing these things. And they do look pretty dope. You know, I think you can obviously wear these out. I have two pairs, one I keep in the house and one I will wear out. I love them. And I think it's crazy that you can get a colorway right now for under $100. And it's one of the nicer colorways. It's a nice, clean, neutral, lighter colorway. So I had to include it on the list. It might not be for everybody, but maybe it's for you. And I hope you'll join me on being part of the Offline 2.0 gang. All right, guys, two more brands and six more sneakers to go. We have moved on to now a brand that, again, like ASICS, I think is very underrated and makes some seriously dope sneakers. That brand is Puma. They make seriously dope products, especially their shoes, one of which I swear by and wear a lot. That would be the Puma RS Legacy Connect. Those, unfortunately, do not hit under that $100 price point, but I do have an RS version for you, so stay tuned. The first one is the Puma Clyde Foils. These are clean, these are crispy, you got a nice gold foil on them. They just look great, and they're not as narrow as some of the other classic Puma sneakers. Those are the ones I kind of shy away from. This one has a nice aesthetic that's kind of in line with the rest of the sneakers we talked about. Maybe that Air Force One replacement, of course. I like to always have that out there for you guys. This is the Puma Clyde. I like the way this looks. It's clean, it's simple, it's elegant. It just looks dope, it looks good. And for the price, come on, you can't beat it. Now, this next one is a little bit funkier, a little bit chunkier, shall we say. This is the Puma California, and it's got that classic Puma upper, but then it's got a very exaggerated, chunky, almost kind of like creeper shoe style midsole and outsole, and it might be a little too much for some, but it might be just the right amount of off for other people. So like, it doesn't take it too far, but definitely far enough, especially with a Puma sneaker, which again, when I think Pumas, I always think of those more narrower sneakers. So I like the way this looks. It's kind of dope. You get a nice suede upper, you get a nice chunky midsole, the Puma California. I mean, I've never seen this one before until making this video. Maybe I'm late, but maybe these are new. I don't know. All I know is that I like them. All right, I told you guys that I was going to have a Puma RS sneaker on here for you. Obviously, a lot of the RS sneakers don't hit under $100. This one is on sale right now. And there are RS sneakers that start full retail price under 100 or at 100, but they're not as good, in my opinion, as these here. These are the Puma RS Connects. And the pair I have, personally, is the RS Connect Legacy that they did a collaboration with Porsche. The colorway is beautiful. The comfort is amazing. The RS stands for running system. It's a running system that Puma developed in the 80s that is still incredibly comfortable and amazing. I love the aesthetic of the RS Connect specifically. When you look at all of the RS sneakers, they definitely do vary. Whether you're looking at an RSX or an RS Fast, the Connects, in my opinion, are the best looking ones, but I also have an RS Fast in this really cool veggie colorway. I think these just look good. They look dope. And of course, under 100 bucks. So I threw those in there for you to check out as well. Puma RS, one of the most comfortable platforms of sneakers in general, definitely my favorite in any line of Puma sneakers. Next up is a Puma basketball sneaker, a vintage Puma basketball sneaker that is in line with your New Balance 550s, the Adidas Forum. So think of that aesthetic. These are the Puma Slipstreams, and the two colorways I have are the Never Worn and the Beauty. The Beauty is a more cleaner colorway, while the Never Worn has got a little bit more going on in terms of material and textures visually and the colors. I love the way both of them look. I think these are seriously dope sneakers that I wish I knew more about or knew of prior to making this video, because I'm definitely, of any of the ones that I'm going to buy off this list, and I'm definitely going to buy a few, these Slipstreams are ones I'm absolutely looking forward to getting in hand and feeling and trying out, because with the growing popularity of the MB550s, I think this 80s basketball aesthetic with these types of sneakers is not going anywhere for the time being, so definitely something dope to rock going through 2022. And finally, that leaves us with the last brand on the list. I know I left out some other brands, so if there's anything else you guys think that can work for this list, put it down in the comments to share with everyone else watching the video. I would appreciate that, because obviously I couldn't hit everything. All right, I'm only one person. But finally, we've got Reebok here, and Reebok has some really dope, iconic, classic sneakers, of course. One that's probably a little obvious for this list and what I set out to do with it, but I'm going to include it anyway, and that's the Reebok Club C, because I think not enough people know about the Club C as a very viable alternative to your everyday all-white sneaker. Club Cs are just that. They're a great silhouette, and they just look good with almost anything, so I always recommend the Club Cs to someone looking for that alternative to the Air Force One, of course. And specifically, I love this off-white colorway that you're seeing here with those little hits of blue. Like, this one looks really good. And of course, you can't go wrong with the crispy or bright white as well. So overall, the Club C, definitely one to check out. And lastly, the Reebok Classic. Again, so many people know about this one, but this Reebok Classic leather colorway that I came across is like, wow, really caught my eye. Definitely one of the few sneakers that I'm going to pick up for myself personally from this list. I love the way that this colorway looks. It's just very much on trend right now, and hopefully whoever is doing this at Reebok right now gets to do some more things, because Reebok has definitely been lacking in certain areas, but they have such a great, beautiful, deep catalog. I'm looking forward to someone taking that and coming up with some seriously dope releases in the near future. Maybe it'll happen, maybe not. Either way, these Reebok Classics in this specific colorway are just phenomenal. What a gorgeous sneaker for under 100 bucks. And that brings us to the end of this list, guys. Thank you so much for sticking with me here. Obviously, I didn't hit every single dope sneaker under 100 bucks, but for my money, these are the 23, 25 or ish so sneakers that you can get for under 100 bucks right now to carry you through 2022. Anything else that you guys are feeling, anything you think I should have put on the list, drop it down in the comments below for everyone else to check out. And I will try to apply with a link to Cop if I can find them. And with all of that being said, guys, if you haven't yet, consider joining the fam on the road to 10,000 subscribers. And I want you guys all to be a part of it. Your likes, comments, subscription, engagements, All of that is what makes the Sneaker Channel great. It's not me, it's you, and I appreciate each and every last one of you. Of course, check out the helpful links down in the description below, as well as all the links for the sneakers we talked about today. They help out the channel. I get a little bit of a kickback. You don't pay any extra. All these bad boys are under 100 bucks. Feel free to use those gift cards you just got for the holidays on some dope sneakers to carry you through this new year. And with all that being said, hope you have a good day, good evening, good night, whenever you're watching this, and I will see you guys on the next one. Peace.